When Jesus appeared in the resurrection form, the disciples were scared at first, of course. They thought that he was a ghost. So the first thing that he did was to try just to reassure them that it was really him. He lets them touch him. "Here, look at the wounds that I have. Touch them," he says. "Touch my hands. Touch my side." And then he simply says, "Hey, do you have anything to eat around here?" Which I love. And they get him a broiled fish, which back then, that's just like getting a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. These were fishermen. That's what they did. They ate fish all the time. There was nothing more normal than eating fish. It was their comfort food. And that's what we do anyway, right? When we want to comfort each other, when we want to reassure each other that everything's going to be okay, we sit down and we eat together. That's what people do, right? So Jesus was comforting them, reassuring them, trying to get them to relax and to not be afraid so they could hear what he had to say. And only after he has calmed them down and they've touched him and they've eaten something with him, only then does he try to explain why he's come back. And he says to the disciples, in the scripture, it foretold that the Messiah was going to suffer and die, and that he would come back to proclaim forgiveness of sins. And so you are to go out and witness and proclaim the forgiveness of sins. Forgiveness of sins. For Jesus, the resurrection and forgiveness were inextricably linked. That if the disciples were going to understand what the resurrection really meant, they had to understand and practice forgiveness. But what in the world is forgiveness, really? Well, we know that Jesus suffered an unjust and horribly violent death, and yet he was able to forgive. The question is, can you forgive and can I? And what does that mean? If we're going to follow Jesus, we have to learn to forgive, but what does that mean? There are so many misunderstandings about forgiveness. They're everywhere. People think that to forgive, you have to say that something is okay. That the hurt that you went through, the pain or the injustice, that it was okay. And that is not true. And then other people think that to forgive means you have to forget something. Like, just get over it. Move on. But the truth is that when we have to go through something really hard, when we suffer, it changes us. We can't just forget. We cannot go back to the way things were. After the cross, when Jesus came back, he had scars. He was changed. And so we are also changed when we have to suffer. There's no denying that. We can't pretend that it didn't happen. And we can't say that it's okay. God did not intend for human beings to suffer. We were not created for that. Suffering is a result of our fall from God. When you suffer, it is not okay. But the only way to forgive is to move through it, as Jesus did, to be changed by it. Forgiveness means letting something go. I think the best analogy I can come up with to describe what forgiveness really not to forget it, not to deny its existence, but to give it to God, to lighten our load, to let God carry it for us. Have you been wronged by people in your life? I know you have. We live in a broken world. Do you carry it with you? Does it weigh you down? There's a reason why Jesus told us to pray in the Lord's Prayer. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. We must understand that forgiveness is essential if we're going to follow Christ. We cannot make our way to God if we don't let go of these things that burden us and weigh us down. Jesus tells us to pray for our enemies. When you pray every day, name the people who made you the most angry. Name the people who have hurt you. Say their names aloud. I know it's hard. But you don't only do it for them, you do it for yourself. To liberate yourself. So that you can follow Christ and do his work in the world. When I was in college, I decided that I was going to go work in a Russian orphanage. Many of you know that I did that. This was before Glasnost, it was before Perestroika, it was during the time of the Soviet Union, before 9/11. And I knew that these children had nothing. They had no toys. So I went to my home parish in New Haven, Connecticut, and I sent out a plea to the entire parish. I'm going to work in a Russian orphanage, and I need you to donate toys. Well, I was so proud of them. These people came through. They donated so many toys that I had to rent a U-Haul truck to get them down to JFK Airport. And we had them in boxes, and volunteers helped me get them into the airport. And you know those long lines at JFK for the check-in? So I'm there with all these boxes, and I finally have everything together. And all of a sudden, it hits me like a thunderbolt. Oh, no. I forgot that there was a weight limit to your luggage. What in the world was I thinking? I was 20 years old. I wasn't thinking. And I had all these toys and no idea how I was going to get them on the airplane. And I felt like I was going to burst into tears. There was this glamorous woman in front of me in the line. Something came over me, and I just said, "Ma'am, excuse me, I'm trying to bring all these toys to the orphans in Russia, and I was wondering, do you think you can take a doll in your suitcase?" She looked at me. Then she got down and unzipped her suitcase, and she looked at me again. By this time, I opened a cardboard box, and I had two dolls like this. She took out her hair dryer. She said, "You know what? I really don't need to bring a hair dryer." And she threw it in the trash. "Give me that doll," she said. The news spread down the line of people at the JFK airport. Next in line was a family of Orthodox Jews. They started throwing away their clothes. Everyone was stuffing toys into their suitcases, crayons, balloons, bubble gum, stuffed animals, balls, games. People were throwing away their belongings to make room for these toys Forgiveness is about making room in your suitcase. Because God has a lot of stuff that you're going to need to serve Him in this world. But if your suitcase is full of these burdens and resentments that you can't seem to get over,